Okay, so some more introduction stuff. And so if we have point A, which is 1, 4, which we'll put here as A, and B is 3, 5, which is here, B, I want to sketch vector AB. So here is vector AB in that direction, and it is going in that direction. Here is the head and the tail. And if I want to write it as a column vector, well, I can see when I look at this that it's going to be 2 in the x direction, and 1 in the y direction. But if how would we get it if we don't want to draw these out all the time? Well, what we do then is we go the head, subtract the tail. It's always the head minus the tail. And so we take our x value, we're going to take the 3, 5 minus the 1, 4. So 3 minus 1 is 2, 5 minus 4 is 1. And so we always go head, tail, and then we will get our column vector, and this is AB. Looking at the next example, let's consider this. We're going to write down vector PQ. Well, first let's draw this out. I have 1, 4 is P, and I have 8, 10 is Q here. And so my vector PQ is here. And I know if I want PQ, I simply take 8 minus 1 is 7, 10 minus 4 is 6. And visually, if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 in the x direction, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up in the y direction, we can clearly see that that is the correct vector. Okay, so there's PQ. Now it says to plot A, which is 5, 2. I'm going to switch to purple. I'm going to go 5, 2 is A. And it says write down PA and AQ. Well, PA then is going to be A and P, so it's 5 minus 1 is 4. And 2 minus 4 is negative 2. It's PA. And if you look here, it's my vector PA. I can go P, I go, that's negative 2 is the Y, and a positive 4 is the X. Similarly, now I want to find AQ. Well, AQ is going to be, if I take Q, 8 minus 5 is 3. And if I go Q, 10 minus 2, 10 minus 2 is 8. And so again, if I take a look at my vector here, I am going to go there. Maybe I'll do it with the green. Here is AQ. So now what I can see is if I go PA plus PQ, if I go PA plus AQ plus AQ, I know that that is 4, negative 2, plus 3, 8, which is 7, and 6. If I look here, 7, 6 was the same as PQ. So PA plus AQ is the same as PQ. And if I look at this diagram here, it illustrates if I start at P, if I go to A, and then A to Q, that is the same result as just going straight from P to Q. And so what this shows, this is the triangle law of vector addition that says AB plus BC is going to equal to AC, because these basically cancel each other out. And it goes on and on. If I went AB, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE, if I added all those up, I would get simply AE. It would be the final vector. And that is the vector law of addition for vectors. And so what it means is that it doesn't matter which path you end up going. So even if I put on a new point here, if I went then from A to here, and then to here, and then to Q, the addition of these vectors would be the same as PQ. And so geometric addition vectors gives the resultant effect of all the vectors being added successively. So it's independent of the root. As long as you start and end and you connect the vectors up, you can clearly add vectors all together. And the resultant, the beginning and the end, is the resultant vector of adding them all up, which is a pretty powerful theorem overall.